Hi, this is Tanya. Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm just going to do a get ready with me kind of. It's a Saturday and I have to go out and I have to run my errands. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do some makeup and I'm going to do my hair and I'm going to show you what I wear when I go out and go grocery shopping and stuff. Just normal stuff, but who knows, maybe in some respects, it will inspire, or oh, I like the way she does, blah, or whatever. And just kind of show you what I do to get ready on a normal weekend when I'm going out and not doing anything particularly exciting. All right, so before we get started, though, we're going to do our 30 days of greatness. So I'm going to pull a quote from here. Let's see if I can get my hands on one. Ooh, I like this one. Good things are going to happen. I can get behind that. All right, so here we go. So I prepped my face as always, and I'm going to be speeding up this get ready with me makeup round a little bit by maybe going off camera and doing some of the actions that I normally would do. I'm using my Stila in medium for my brows, and I'm just going to go fill those in and then I'll be right back. All right, so I just got done filling in my eyebrows. Now I'm going to brush them up just with a regular brush here, just kind of control the hairs I do have. And then I'm going to go ahead and prep my lids for shadow by putting my Maybelline Fit Me concealer, which now, if you can see, is almost down. I've almost used it all. I like when I use up products because then I get to go buy more. But it's so funny because I wonder if any YouTubers who do makeup tutorials and stuff, if they actually really just finish all the products they ever buy. I doubt it. It's virtually impossible, I think, especially when you have so many choices. You've got 20 or 30 foundations. How are you ever going to finish all of those? It would take you years and then they would pass their expiration date, right? Anyway, all right, so just prepping. I'm using an e.l.f. brush. This is actually, what is this? This is like a crease brush or something, but I demoted it to this because I didn't want to necessarily always spread it with my fingers, although I do that a lot. This doesn't work as well, by the way. It does work better if you spread it with your fingers. Take some of the excess off there. I got a lot going on. All right, and then I set it with the Pacifica powder. I really love this powder. This is shade one. They have shade one and shade two. It's so funny. It's kind of like Dr. Seuss, shade one and shade two. But I use my e.l.f. brush for this too and just pat it over and set it. But I do love this powder. There's like no dust off. It's amazing, amazing powder. Good stuff in it, and it is talc free. All right, ready, set, go. What are we doing for eyeshadow today? Okay, we're gonna go basic here, I think. Let me select something out. I'll be right back. All right, so I've selected the Wet n Wild Quad in Silent Treatment. So these are more brownsies and taupesies. And one thing I'd like to mention is these quads generally have one matte and three shimmers. The matte is the crease color. I don't particularly like this crease color, so I'm going to go ahead and use this one here. It's more taupey and it looks shimmery, but you know what? It is shimmery, but it just really works good for a crease color. I think it's just the range of color, if that makes any sense, than it is. Oh, crease brush. Let's use this one. This is my Morphe. I'll put all this down in the description box below. No worries. All right, so we're going to use the Morphe. And I love this color. It's nice taupe. It's very subtle. Generally, I don't wear loud makeup during you know, any really time. I mean, but I do like to play with that. So we're just going to put that in the crease there. This is going to be such a simple look. And then we're going to go with the what crease color there. I'm going to lay that on my lid. This is an interesting color. It's kind of like a pinky taupe, but it's very dusty, like a dusty rose taupe. It's very interesting. All right, and then I'm going to go ahead with this highlighter here. And I'm just going to put that in here. And just below there. All right. And I'm going to do the rest of my makeup and I'll be right back. All right. I just finished putting on my foundation and I used the cushion one from Wet n Wild. And I'll put the color down below. I tried the new sponge, a total face sponge from e.l.f. And boy, this thing really blew up. Look at how big it is compared to the Real Techniques. Is this a Real Techniques? You know, I actually forgot which one this one is, but look at how huge this thing is. It's like, it's so big. I don't like it. I like to be able to get in the corners and the creases and up around here. Not happy with this sponge. It was $5. And when I added water to it, it was like, ugh. So I wanted a little bit more coverage today because the sun's going to come out and we're going to be taking, I think we're going to go for a walk later, and I don't want to expose myself too much to the sun there. So, because I normally do my powder, but all right, so what am I doing? I am doing, oh, and I didn't put on my primer. That's okay. I'm kind of waiting for this to dry. And then I think I'm going to go with my blush, and I haven't quite decided what blush I'm going to do. I think I'm going to go with my Rimmel 3-in-1. Go ahead with the contour. Let's see, what am I contouring today right here? I'm going to use my contour as a bronzer because it's nice and light for my skin tone. That's something you can do. You can use your contour as your bronzer instead of wearing bronzer. But I wanted a little bit today. I actually like that, the kind of bronzy. I'm just going to add some of the highlighter and the blush all together. We're just going to do all of it together. It does work with this particular one. So there we go. Kind of warm, bronzy. And then I'm just going to do, oh, I'm going to do my brown eyeliner from Wet n Wild. And then I'm going to finish it off with my Neutrogena. If I can find it, I'll find it, Neutrogena mascara. I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm back. So I finished doing my makeup. It's kind of like a golden, glowy summertime look. And now I'm going to do my hair. I think I'm going to do an updo today. So I'm going to take this hair here. I'm going to do a two-part updo, which means I want kind of a loose look. I don't want to do it like totally like taunt. So I'm going to use my scrunchie clips, these little clippies here, and I'm just going to do this. I'm going to put this back here. So I'm just putting this section up. And I will explain why I'm doing this when I pull my mirror here. I'll show you the back. Okay, so here's the back. I'm just putting it up here. I got a cover up. I have a cowl there. It's funny. You can see my white and you can see where I still have my, well, but I'm not gray all the way to the back of my head. I'm very dark in the back, just naturally. All right, so there, I put that back there just like that. And the reason I did that is because I want to make this more loose up here rather than having a really super tight pullback. And then I'm just going to grab all the hair back here. And I'm just going to, I got my regular big claw scrunchy one. These are great because they put rubber in them now, so they hold. I'm just going to twist this, and I'm just going to leave it kind of loose, and I'm just going to drag it across here and just and loosen it a little bit. Let it be a little bit loose like that. And I'm going to actually let, does that work? Yeah, I got the top and the bottom there. So I have this top one and the bottom one here. And then I'm just going to let these little tendrils come down and take my curling iron, my brush curling iron, and just get those tendrils to kind of like that. Just want to kind of have a little bit of a looser look today. Like that. Just style the bangs a little bit. Sometimes I just drag this brush across, and this works really good too. Instead of curling it, I just use it as a straight by just dragging it like that. I love this curling iron. It's got the brush on it. Works really good. There. Kind of like do that, and then I take my Fruit Tea Shine spray, or no, actually I take my Pantene Air spray first. Give it a spray. Make sure everything is how I want it. And then give it a shot of the Fruit Tea spray for shine. There, that shines my bangs. There we go. So, and then I'm going to need to use my my clips, my clear combs here that I get. I think these are Goodie. And I'm going to put them in both sides, but I'm going to push them forward. I'm going to take them, once I put them in, take my fingers, and I'm going to push them forward. And what's that? That's going to do is it's going to make this area look a little fuller. Gives you that kind of nice old-fashioned updo look. So it's up here, it's high here, and it's high here. Gives you that kind of nice little look, just a little different than pulling it all back so tight. So that's going to be my look for today. And then let me show you what I'm wearing. I am wearing a white t-shirt today. Oh, the lighting in here is not good. There we go. Let me step back. I'm wearing a white t-shirt, and I'm wearing my distressed jeans. Let me come back in here, show you. Shoes are these cute shoes here. I got, they're like deck shoes, I guess. They're like Keds deck shoes. Here, let me take one off. They're like this. They're cute. Little deck shoes like that, and I wear them with no socks. Now, if you love these shoes, but you need arch supports, I bought these little Air Plus arch supports here, which you get at Walgreens for $10, and you just slip them inside, and they're really super duper comfortable. And then, you know, I don't even have a belt on. I'd usually wear a white t-shirt, and if I'm going out, I might bring a light sweater in case the weather is not good. And then I've got my little Lucky Brand watch on, a nice simple watch with a leather band, either brown or tan, or white is nice too. And I just usually keep it simple for a Saturday or something. Anyway, so that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. I'll put everything in the description box below. Click subscribe, and we'll catch you next time. Bye.